Hello, this is Eric at Really Right Stuff, and today I'm going to be talking about how to choose the right nodal slide for your equipment. As you can see here, we have quite a range of different nodal slide options, ranging from our B150B all the way down to our B2 Fab mini clamp. The standard nodal slide that we offer with our pano packages, both in the single row and the multi-row, is this, our MPR-CL2. I'd say this meets the needs of about 90% of our photographers. This is everything you need for non-collared lenses and standard focal range lenses. This will, however, not work for your needs if you have either an extremely wide-angle prime lens on a full-frame body, such as something around the lines of 15 to 16 millimeters in the prime area, as well as if you're trying to shoot with a collared telephoto lens, something like a 70 to 200 2.8. If you're wanting to shoot with either of those two situations, you're going to need a slightly different nodal slide. So that's what we have these other options here for. For starting with the wide angle solution, the reason that the standard MPR-CL2 does not work is because the rail is actually too long. If you were to look through the viewfinder of a full frame camera body with a wide angle lens, you would actually begin to see the front end of the rail showing up in your frame. To test this, if you're not certain if this is going to be an issue, what you can do is you can set up your camera and lens, the lens in question, set it on a tabletop, and then you want to have your lens facing the edge of the tabletop, scoot the camera away from the edge of the table up until you start to see the edge of the table come into your field of view. Once you see that, go ahead and scoot forward so it's no longer in your field of view, and then measure the distance from the front edge of the table to the back edge of your camera, and that will give you the longest distance that you have to work with. So as I was saying, if your maximum distance that you have is shorter than 7.5 inches, you're going to need to go with something shorter, like our MPR-CL. The newer design versions have a laser engraved scale along the top surface, and this will allow you kind of the repeatable measurements similar to what our MPR-CL2 has along the side. It does not, however, have the large spirit level for reference. Lastly, for the wide angle, you have the option of getting an adjustable slide. Either our 192 Precision Plus package, which is probably our most versatile nodal slide, or an FAS clamp package, as here, where you can adjust the length of the rail so that if you need to, it's slightly shorter in front of you. Lastly, we have the B150B. This will achieve the same effect. You have the option of sliding the rail so that it'll be slightly shorter in front. However, this is a little bit of overkill and again does not have the built-in spirit level like all of these three do. For photographers who are wanting to use a collared telephoto lens, such as a 70 to 200 2.8, one of the main issues there is actually the dovetail orientation of the clamp. Our standard MPR-CL2, the dovetail orientation runs left-right, which is appropriate for a camera body plate, such as one of our L plates, but is not appropriate for a telephoto lens plate. In that situation, you need something that is fore-aft oriented. So you need something like, again, the 192 Precision Plus package here, where you have the ability to reposition these mini clamps so that the dovetail orientation is fore-aft, as well as the option of having it go left-right. This does, however, require the use of a hex key in order to change the orientation of the mini clamps, but it is by far the most flexible. The FAS package is non-adjustable in that regard, and so it will not work. Same with the B150B. If you already have an MPR-CL2 and you don't want to get an entirely new rail, you do have the option of adding one of our B2 Fab mini clamps. This is our B2 Fab-F, as you can see here, and it has a flat back bottom, but it still has the dovetails, our Arca Swiss compatible dovetails machined in the bottom of the clamp in the opposite orientation. Those dovetails, when combined with the existing built-in clamp, will actually change the dovetail orientation so that it's now fore aft instead of being left right. As you can see here, you don't have any positionability as far as the clamping surface in relation to the rail itself, like the 192 Precision Plus, but you do have a rather efficient solution for changing the dovetail orientation. And so in summary, we would recommend the MPR-CLII again for about 90% of the users out there. If you have either a collared telephoto lens or a extremely wide angle lens, you're gonna wanna use a different rail. In those situations, for the wide angle lenses, I would recommend the MPR-CL or the 192 Precision Plus package. These are gonna be your best options for the wide angle lenses. For collared telephoto lenses, you'll want to go with either the 192 Precision Plus package, as shown here, or using the B2Fab-F mini clamp with the standard MPR-CL2, and that will give you the dovetail orientation you need. And that sums up our nodal slide options. If you still have any questions, feel free to give us a call or send us an email. Once again, this is Eric thanking you for watching.